Then we have to supply external memory.
Then we have to interface external memory to microcontroller. That is what we have studied, isn't it? So today I'm going to repeat little bit of that, and then we will be studying how to interface the RAM, that is random access memory, externally to 8051. Okay, so first we will discuss about how to externally interface the ROM or the read only memory to 8051. So while studying this, initially what we have studied, how to find the number of address lines required to interface the memory. Okay, so how to find number of address lines, students? What formula is there? Yes, tell me fast, be fast. Number of address lines are related to size of the memory.
16 into 1 KB.
So size of the memory is equal to 2^2 address lines. This formula you have to remember. So if 16 KB is the size of the memory, then 16 KB we will calculate the number of address lines like 16 KB is equal to 16 into 1 KB. 16 means 2^4 and 1 KB means 2^10. So it will be 2^4 into 2^10, which will be equal to 2^14. So number of address line required for 16 KB of memory is 14. And with 8051, we have 16 address lines. So out of 16 address lines, we are going to use 14 address lines for interfacing to ROM. And remaining two lines will be using for chip select signal. Okay, so that is what we have seen. So here, what you can observe on the screen, students? Yes, which are the blocks that you can observe on the screen? Tell me. Be fast, be fast, be fast. You have to talk. The lecture should be two-way. It should not be one-way. That shows your involvement. Yes, Vedant.
8051. Latch and ROM.
What is the use of the latch here? What is the use of the latch?
To lock the address.
To lock the lower order address, because lower order address is multiplexed with the data. And to demultiplex this and to lock the address, the latch is used. So this is how you have to write answer in examination, and you should explain. Okay, so learn how to explain orally, and also learn how to explain in written manner also. So both are very important skills. Okay, so now to interface memory, external memory to the microcontroller, we need three blocks. Of course, we need 8051 microcontroller, we need ROM, that is read only memory, and along with this we will need a latch. Okay, now for 8051, what I am showing over here, you have to apply power supply to the 8051. Okay, so that you have to apply between the pin VCC and the pin ground. So here you can observe the power supply pins of 8051, VCC and ground. Thereafter, what I am using here, what you can observe on the screen on 8051 block. So what I have written here? Yes, tell me what I have written here. What is this?
PSEN.
Yes, PSEN is also there. But now what I have written, what I have underlined. What is this?
Port 2.
Port 2.8 to port 2.13. What is purpose of this port? The purpose of this port is to send upper address, upper byte or higher byte of the address. Okay, so higher order address lines must be connected to P2.8 to P2.13 because we will need only 14 address lines. And they start from A0 to A13. They end up to A13. So we will require port pins P2.8 to port pins P2.13 in order to connect the higher order address of 8051 to the higher order address. Here you can observe higher order address of the ROM. Are you getting the point? Higher order address of the ROM. So here you can observe A8 to A13. That means what will be our connection? We should provide connection between P2.8 to P2.13, and this connection must be made to the A8 to A13 of the read-only memory. Okay, are you getting the point? So this connection we have to make. So what here we have done? We have connected the address bus from P2.8 to P2.13. Are you getting the point? And this must be connected to A8 to A13 of the ROM. Okay. So now let us see next what I have written over the 8051 block. What is this? Yes, tell me, what is this? Yes, students, what is this? Yes, read it. Vedan, what is this?
P0.0 to P0.7.
And this must be connected where?
D0 to D7.
Both to D0 to D7 and A0 to A7. It is because 0 to 7 lines are multiplexed. We have two sets. One is lower address of the lower order byte of the address and the data byte. Both of these are multiplexed. Okay. So during the first clock pulse, the 8051 will output the lower order address. During the second clock pulse, it will output the data. Okay. And we have to separate this lower address and the data. So how we are going to separate it? We are going to separate it through a component which is called as a latch. Okay. So let us see how to do that. So now I have connected this P0.0 to P0.7 to latch. And you can observe this is a bidirectional arrow. Why bidirectional arrow? Because it is outputting both address as well as data, and data bus is a bidirectional bus. Okay. Now after this, you can observe what I have connected. I have connected ALE to the EN pin of the latch. What is ALE? Address latch enable. Okay. And what is EN? EN is the enable pin. Okay. So what happens? The 8051 initially outputs the lower order address on the bus. And when it outputs the lower order address on the bus, at the same time, it activates the pin address latch enable or ALE, and this pin ALE will activate the enable pin of the latch. And therefore what will happen? The lower order address which was placed on the bus is now transferred into the latch. Okay, so this is what is happening. Thereafter, this latch is connected to the lower order address bus of the ROM. So whatever address present in the latch will be transferred to the lower order address lines of the ROM. Okay, now what happens after latching the address? What 8051 does, 8051 deactivates, okay, or disables the ALE pin. And when it disables the ALE pin, the enable pin of the latch is also disabled. And as the enable pin of the latch is disabled, it will hold the lower order address within itself, and it will not take any input from the bus. Okay, because now it is disabled. Okay, काय केलं जातं, पहिल्यांदा address ह्याच्यामध्ये lock केला जातो. एकदा का address lock केला तर ALE deactivate होतं. ALE deactivate झाल्यामुळे तुमचा latch disable होतो. Latch disable झाल्यामुळे पुढे काही या बस वर चेंजेस झाले तर ते लॅच मध्ये येत नाही. पूर्वीचाच ऍड्रेस या लॅच मध्ये प्रेझेंट असतो आणि जो कुठे दिला जातो ऍड्रेस बसला. सो व्हेन ALE सिग्नल इज डिसेबल्ड, द 8051 मायक्रो कंट्रोलर सेंड्स द डेटा ओव्हर द सेम बस. अँड नाऊ व्हॉट हॅपन्स, ऍज लॅच इज डिसेबल्ड, द डेटा विल नॉट बी transported to latch, but it is transported to the data lines of the read-only memory. So in this way, with help of the latch and with the help of the ALE signal, the multiplexed address and data lines are demultiplexed. Demultiplexed means they are separated. Initially they were mixed. Afterwards, they are separated into address lines as well as data lines. Okay. Now, you can observe what I am connecting here. I am connecting PSEN. PSEN. What is the long form of PSEN? Program Store Enable. So this program store enable pin, which is active low of 8051, must be connected to output enable of the ROM, and that is what we have connected. Now thereafter, you can observe what I have written over here, students. What is this? P3.7 port 3 is used to generate the control signals for external memory. And the control signals for the external memory are read and write. Obviously, as this is a ROM, we will require only read pin. We will not require write pin. But here I have shown both read and write pins. Okay. P3.7 is a read pin. P3.6 is a write pin. So in this case, we are going to use only P3.7. So read pin of the ROM must be connected to P3.7 of 8051. So this will be our next connection. Okay. Now, thereafter, what you can observe, students, what you can observe here, what I have drawn, what is this? Can anybody tell me?
AND gate.
It is AND gate. Okay. So AND gate is used for CS. What is the meaning of CS? Meaning of the CS is the chip select. Okay. So many times what happens, we use number of chips, not a single chip, but number of chips. And we have to select a particular chip. And that particular chip can be selected when this particular signal is activated. So in this particular case, this chip select signal is active high. So when this chip select signal is made one, this particular chip will be selected. And these chip select signals are derived from the unused address lines. So here you can observe A14 address line and A15 address line of 8051. They are unused. Why? because 8051 has 16 bit address lines and we need only 14 bit address lines to connect a ROM of size 16 KB. Okay, so here A14 and A15 are the address lines which are unused, and these two address lines are used to select the chip. So every time you want to select the chips, what you have to do is you have to make this signal 1. Okay, so when you make it 1, the chip will be selected. Okay, so after this, what happens? What you can observe is here one more pin you need to connect, and that pin is EA. If you remember, what is EA pin? Can anybody tell me what is EA pin? EA pin is present with 8051. Long form of EA is external access, and this external access is active low. It is EA bar, and this external access should be connected to ground, because when you make it logic 0, it will be activated. That means when external access is activated, you can interface the external memory to microcontroller. Okay, so this is how we interface the read-only memory to microcontroller. Okay, so in a similar way, now we are going to see how to interface the RAM or random access memory to 8051. Okay, are you clear about this initially, students? Are you clear about ROM interface, or do you have any doubts? If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Yes, speak up. बोलत काय रे तुम्ही लोक? समजतंय समजत नाही, मला काही समजायला तयार नाही.
मॅम ते ग्रीन कलरची जी लाईन आहे ना, ती कोणती बस येतो?
ती ही मल्टीप्लेक्स्ड बस आहे, ऍड्रेस आणि डेटा मिळून. त्याच्यावर ऍड्रेस लाईन पण वापरलेल्या आहेत आणि डेटा लाईन्स पण वापरलेल्या आहेत.
मॅम आणि ते ब्राऊन आणि रेड कलरची लाईन ती कुठली? ते कोणते बस आहेत?
आता ही जी आहे ही ऍड्रेस बस आहे, हायर ऑर्डर ऍड्रेस, A8 पासून A13 पर्यंत. हायर ऑर्डर आणि लोअर ऑर्डर ह्या डिवाइड केलेल्या आहेत त्याच्यामध्ये. ओके, लोअर ऑर्डरचे 8 बिट्स आणि हायर ऑर्डरचे 8 बिट्स असतात, पण ह्यातले 8 बिट न वापरता आपण फक्त 13 पर्यंत वापरतो, कारण आपल्याला फक्त 14 लाईन्सच लागत आहे. त्यामुळे उरलेल्या दोन लाईन ज्या आहेत त्या अनयुज्ड असतात, त्यामुळे इथे फक्त 13 पैकी ज्या वरच्या लाईन आहेत 8 पासून 13 पर्यंत त्या इथे जोडलेल्या आहेत ब्राऊन कलरमध्ये. ही ऍड्रेस बस आहे, ही ऍड्रेस कॅरी करते. जनरली ऍड्रेस हा मायक्रो कंट्रोलर पासून दुसरीकडे कॅरी केला जातो, आणि ही कशी असते बस? युनिडायरेक्शनल असते. ओके, आता दुसरी गोष्ट म्हणजे इथे बघा, इथे काय केलंय आपण, इथे मिक्स आहेत ना आपले ऍड्रेस आणि डेटा लाईन्स, त्यामुळे इथे हे बाय डायरेक्शनल दाखवलंय की ग्रीन मध्ये मिक्स आहेत म्हणून ग्रीन कलर दाखवलाय. पण ह्या लॅचच्या साह्याने आपण ऍड्रेस बस सेपरेट केली ना, मग आता लोअर ऑर्डर ऍड्रेस ह्या ब्राऊन मध्ये आहे, A0 to A7. राहिलेलं रेड काय आहे आपलं? तर डेटा बस आहे, ही डेटा बस आहे. आलं का लक्षात?
हो मॅम.
अजून कुणाला काही शंका मुलांना? अजून कुणाला काही शंका आहे का?
नो मॅम.
नो. सो वी विल सी हाऊ टू इंटरफेस रॅम. ओके, सो हिअर we are going to interface the random access memory to microcontroller, external RAM interface, external RAM interface, external RAM interface we are going to study. Okay, now here we will be interfacing, we'll be interfacing 8 KB of RAM, 8 KB of RAM, 8 KB of RAM to 8051. So now can you tell me how to calculate the number of address lines required for 8 KB of RAM? Can anybody tell me? Yes. Yes, how to do calculations regarding the number of address lines?
2 raised to n.
2 raised to n. 8K. Okay. I will write here 8K is equal to 8 into 1K. Okay. So after this, what you have to write here? What you have to write is this is equal to, this is again equal to 8 is what? It is 2 raised to 3, isn't it? 2 raised to 3. And 1K is what? 2 raised to 10. So both of these must be multiplied with each other. So here I'm going to write 2 raised to 2 raised to 3. And here I'm going to write 2 raised to 10. Okay. So 2 raised to 10 multiplied by 2 raised to 3. How much it is? This will be equal to 2 raised to how much? Yes, students, tell me. How much 13. It is? 2 raised to
13.
2 raised to 13. Okay. So here what you can observe, here you can observe that these 13 lines are nothing but the number of address lines, isn't it? These are address lines. So how many address lines we require? We require 13 address lines. Okay. So how many address lines we require? We require 13 address lines for 8 KB of RAM. So this address calculation is very, very important and you must know this. Okay. Now let us see how to connect the RAM, how to connect the RAM to 8051. Okay. So which components you will require, students? Which components you will require? Obviously, you will require 8051. You will require latch, isn't it? So in this case also, we want to separate out the address and data bus. Similarly, we want a RAM. Okay. So what is this? This is 8051. 8051. And what is this? This is latch. And what is this? This is RAM. Okay, so these three components we will require. Okay, as usual, now what you will require here? Plus VCC, isn't it? So we will require a plus VCC. So here, what you have to do? You have to connect plus VCC here. This particular point is a plus VCC point. Okay. So here we are going to connect a power supply. Now after this, what we will do? We are going to connect the external access. Okay. So we are going to connect the external access. And to where this external access must be connected? This must be connected to ground. This must be connected to ground. So what is this? This is a external access. EA bar. It must be EA bar. Okay. So this is EA bar. And this EA bar must be connected to ground because we are connecting external RAM. And in order to access the external RAM, EA should be logic zero. So that is what I have done here. Okay. Now, tell me, what about the lower order address bus, students? What about the lower order address bus? Where it must be connected?
Latch.
It must be connected to latch. Okay. So I will wipe this out because I'm not getting. Okay, so what I have to do is I have to connect the bidirectional bus to latch, isn't it? And this is lower order address bus along with the data bus. So it starts from P0.0 and it goes up to P0.7. So all 8-bit bus, lower order 8-bit bus must be connected to latch. Okay. Now after this, we will need a higher order address bus, isn't it? And as you know, this is a unidirectional bus. So this unidirectional bus, we are going to connect here. So how many address lines we require? We require 13 address lines. 8 already we have connected. That means 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So how many more address lines you will require? You will require 5 more address lines. And these 5 more address lines we are taking from the higher order address bus, and that must be connected to port 2. So port 2.0 to port 2.4. So this gives 5 address lines, 5 higher order address lines. So they must be connected to the address lines, higher order address lines, that is starting from A8 to A12, because we are using 13 lines and first line is A0. Okay, so here from latch we will separate out the lower order address. Okay, and our lower order address, it starts from A0 and it ends to A7. Okay, so A0 to A7 and upper address A8 to A12. So like this, 13 address lines are used here. Now after this, we are going to connect the data bus. Okay, and how is this data bus, students? The data bus is bidirectional, isn't it? So here you have to connect the data bus to the data bus of the RAM. Okay. So from here, it will go to data bus of RAM. So what is the width of the data bus? Again, it is 8 bits. So it starts from D0 and it goes up to D7. So these are the 8 bits, D0 to D7. So we have connected address bus. We have also connected the data bus. Okay. Now what we have to connect? We have to connect the read line and write line. Okay. So let us connect read line and write line. Okay. So first, I'm going to connect the read line of 8051 to the read line of ROM. Okay. So here I must write, here what should I write? I should write RD. And this should be capital RD. And it is not merely RD, but it is RD, RD bar. It is RD bar. Okay. So this is RD bar. Now we are going to connect the write line. Okay. So we are going to connect the write line to the write line of the RAM. Okay. So here I will connect the write line of the RAM. Okay. So this is how I'm going to connect it. So what is this? This is WR, capital WR, and its bar. WR and its bar. So this is what is write bar. Okay. So at this end, these read and write pins must be connected to which port, students? Yes, tell me. कुठल्या पोर्टला रीड आणि राईट लाइन्स कनेक्ट करायचे आहेत? 0, 2, 3 कुठल्या पोर्टला?
3, port 3.
Port 3. So pin number for write line is P3.6. And that for read line is, या रीडचा कलर जरा वेगळा करू म्हणजे आपल्याला ते मार्क आउट होईल. तर इथे वी हॅव टू कनेक्ट P3.7. ओके. सो P3.7 इज यूज्ड फॉर रीड अँड P3.6 इज यूज्ड फॉर राईट. सो इन दिस वे वी आर कनेक्टिंग द कंट्रोल.